was motivated by the desire to increase students' educational prospects, particularly those from modest socioeconomic backgrounds, and he has made a big difference. In these lessons, Ken integrates issues such as environmental science and sustainability into multimedia projects. His commitment to increasing the educational outcomes of science students across New South Wales has been demonstrated as the founder and coordinator of the iSTEM programme. As a participant in NASA's India Spaceward Bound programme, he has also delivered workshops and courses to Indian teachers. You've got around, Ken, haven't you? In 2015, he was invited under the Australia-India Education Council's Eminent Lecturer Research Programme to undertake science outreach activities with students and teachers in India. In conjunction with his participation in the NASA India Spaceward Bound Programme in the Ladakh region, he delivered teacher workshops to over 200 science teachers in Government of India schools, Delhi State Government schools and private schools. In addition, he also recorded an online science lesson for India's National Institute for Open Schooling, which will reach an amazing over 2.5 million students. Ken's ability to drive innovation and effective practices has been recognised with a number of honours. The New South Wales Engineering and Science Award for Innovation in Mathematics and Science Teaching, a National Educational Leadership Award, a Microsoft Innovator Award, and numerous other teaching and community awards. And in 2015, Ken was awarded the Prime Minister's Prize for Secondary Science Teaching, the highest teaching honour of its type in Australia. So over to you, Ken.
Thank you. Thank you. Am I coming through the microphone okay? Oh, great. I love this because you don't have to yell, you don't have to raise your voice, and it's pretty cool. I might start singing, that's all. On the program, I talk about iSTEM. Everybody knows what STEM is. When we created the program, we actually wanted it to be what kids would like. So we stuck an I in front of it, like iPads and an iPod. So that was the only absolute reason for it. But put up your hand if you've got a science background. Oh, terrific. Look, I'm going to let everybody in on this. Actually, if I talk about H2O, I'm talking about water. Okay. Right. Now I'm going to show you a slide, and I'll actually read through a little bit of it. But I always tell people about water as being H2O, okay? And if you wanted to be really formal, you could say it was dihydrogen monoxide. So di for two. It's a nice tie. Okay. Look, I should be remiss if I didn't say thank you to Sonny Varkey and Sheikh Mohammed. Just getting everybody together has been absolutely awesome.
Yes.
It has.
Yes.
And, okay, I'll just read this. Ken has been a science teacher for 25 years. He has easy access to chemicals. For the past 9 years, he has been adding dihydrogen monoxide to his morning coffee. Ken is now addicted. Without DHMO, he will die in 3 days. He continues to teach. And the reason I tell people now about dihydrogen monoxide and water is because in the past, when I've done this and people don't know about dihydrogen monoxide, half of the room will think, oh, this poor man, he's going to die if he doesn't have this drug. And the other half, they're sitting on the end of their seat going, this is disgusting. Why is he in front of students? But it's amazing, unless people know about science, it's very easy to get confused. I was amazed, my big push is on science by doing, but I was amazed when I came into this building, there's Engage and Inspire. They already stuck it up on the outside for me. I also include Educate because in Australia, going back about 10 years ago, it was really just the big key thing was to get kids engaged. So that just meant you had fun. And I think we've got to go past having fun. We've got to make sure that we actually educate students, so students learn. And that's really important. And we hope that somewhere along the line we inspire students. Okay, I come from Australia. Okay, and in fact, I live in New South Wales, just about here, in a place called Mittagong. Now, Australia, you've probably heard about the Sydney Opera House.
Yes.
Okay, who's here from India? Okay, the Lotus Temple looks exactly the same, but I think the Opera House got there first. we've got the Sydney Harbour Bridge. But wherever you go around the world, you will always see this same bridge, but we're the only one that's got Sydney in front of it. As a bit of an introduction, my family, I've got four children. My wife's in here somewhere, so I'll really embarrass her at the corner there. This is my daughter, my daughter-in-law, and one of our crazy dogs, Alan, who's actually now trained as a paramedic, and really good. Dave, whose job is chopping down trees and makes lots of money doing that. Then there's Bradley. He's the cool dude of the family. and the next one, the next slide, you have to go, This is my grandson, William, and I'll talk more about William later. And this is Echo, our dog. The last time I did a trip actually to India, I phoned home or by Skype, and I was talking to my daughter. And if ever your parents ask, "Are you missing us?" you always have to say yes. Okay, even if you're not. Well, my daughter said, "No, no one's missing you." The only living thing that was missing me was my dog, because she'll come in and sit by my chair. Yeah, she's beautiful. Okay, and just so it looks like I'm a cool dude. Okay, but there we go. One of the things when you do teach is you cannot be super good in the classroom unless you've got the support of other teachers that are doing good things. And I'm just so fortunate that I've got some great teachers and some great students. That's them doing their Superman pose and doing some work outside. And girls especially love, I pick up lots of garbage and electrical stuff and we pull it to pieces. And the girls tend to like that. Okay. One of my heroes, this was my music teacher I had through high school. Unfortunately, Bill Fraser passed away last year. But if I was to give you some homework, can you think about your favourite teacher that you had when you were at school and give them a call, send them a letter and just say thank you. Okay, Einstein. Einstein was, amazing scientist. I will show you one thing. He's actually pointing to where? He's pointing up here to his brain. Which finger is he using? Okay, like this finger. Can I tell you, if ever you take selfies, always check the selfie before you put it out there on the web, because this is what will happen. I gave the Einstein lectures in Sydney for their science festival. The Telegraph came out. They took the photo of me. This was the photo that appeared. And it actually, I don't think they realised, but my students picked it up, that it didn't look like it was that finger. Okay. But look, with Einstein, people always picture Einstein as being really super old. But just remember, he was young, and at one stage, he was in a classroom. So, in your class, the chances are you're going to have someone just like Einstein. Yeah. Okay. Okay, we're going to do some... one of the reasons why we do need to do STEM Australia's got droughts at the moment. All around the world at the moment, there's floods, climate change, and trying to find enough food to save the planet. I mean, eventually it's not going to be enough. So, all these other pressures, even like changing the way that we produce electricity instead of using coal. Okay. This is William, so I'm going to put William on the back, but I just need a volunteer. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. That's right. This is, stand there on the chair for me, please. Okay. I actually did a safety thing before I looked up to make sure there's no fans. Okay. In the textbooks, it will say about balance with our ears. Now, balance is partly with our ears, but let's do a bit of an activity. I want you to actually lean forward like you're Superman. Okay.
Oh my God.
Cool. He's really good, isn't he? Okay. Great. Okay, stand up for me. Terrific. This time, now I'm going to stand here, and if you feel like you're going to fall, I'll catch you. Okay, so just lean forward again. Okay, now when I get to two, I'm going to ask him to close his eyes. Okay, if you do feel like you're falling, just open up. Okay, one, two. Oh, okay, that'll do us. Cool. Can we give him a clap? Yeah, well done. That was all. Was it? High-tech stuff. But look, when we talk about balance for humans, we actually balance basically because of our eyesight. And if ever you've been seasick, it's because you're on the boat. The boat's doing this. So your eyes actually detect that there's no motion, but your ears do. So there's that bit of conflict within your brain, and your brain thinks, it's probably something that you've actually ate that's poisonous. So you vomit, and that you just empty your stomach contents. And the other thing, too, is if ever you take students on a trip in a bus, you always have to have a container for someone to vomit in. Well, you need to actually have three containers, because straight away when you smell someone that's vomited, then you think, the brain thinks it's probably something that they've ate, so you're going to want to vomit. So put the lid on super, super fast. Okay. Right, the key for what we need is education. One of the great things which is happening now is there's a push for girls to be involved in education. This is Albert Einstein. Okay, he's just here. And there's only one lady in the Academy of Science back here. I don't know what she was doing there. She might have snuck in, might have been the tea lady. But back in those days, girls did not get involved in science. And I think it's just amazing that we've lost so much of our intelligence that should have gone into science back in those days that we've just lost. Okay. Now, if there's one thing which has changed the way that I do things in class, and in fact, if I... Could you just grab my backpack for me, the blue one there, please? One of the things which we've changed at our school is every science classroom, near the door, we've got this. So if you've learnt something, give me five. Thank you very much. And so we have that stuck up on the door, and it is terrific because students normally don't clap at the end of a lesson, but when they leave the classroom, if they've learnt something, they give it a high five. So you hear this thump as they leave. And it's really good because it also reinforces to them that they've learnt something, that they just haven't been in the classroom and just been having a good time or copying stuff from the textbook. Okay. We're going to be making some rockets in a moment, but what I'd like to do is just a very quick experiment with you. If you feel uncomfortable closing your eyes, then just keep your eyes open. But if you'd like to, I'll just get you to close your eyes and relax for me. So don't go to sleep, just close your eyes and relax. Now, I'm going to ask you just one question. And that question is, what is your favourite food? So just think about your favourite food. Terrific. Okay, eyes open. Okay, if I point to you, can you tell me what your favourite food... You can open up your eyes now, please. just so we don't have people falling asleep. Favourite food? Indian food and curry, yep.
Biryani rice.
Oh, okay, biryani rice. Cool. Favourite food?
Durian.
Oh, what's that? Oh, is that the fruit?
Yeah.
Oh, right, that you're not allowed to take out of Indonesian. Oh, right. Favourite food?
Bananas.
Okay. Put up your hand if you saw the word of your favourite food. Anybody? Did you see the word? Yeah, when you had your eyes closed, did you see the word banana? No. But I will guarantee if it was your favourite food, you would have seen it in colour and you would have seen a picture of it. Okay? So just think about that. When we get students to write lots and lots of notes, if you want them to learn something that's going to stay in their brain, well, most of the time it's actually as pictures. Okay? So get them to do writing, but also put pictures to it, because when they go to sleep, you know, and they go through their rapid eye movement and they dream, they're going to store all of that stuff in their brain as pictures. And the other way too is they store things as emotions. So there'll be certain things in your life, like when you get married, when you have kids, all of those things you will never forget because it's such a nice experience. The same thing happens if it's a really bad experience. But if you can be relaxed in the classroom and it's a nice feeling, then you actually learn. Okay, we are going to make a rocket and a tick. Does everybody want to make a rocket?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay. I'm very, very quickly going to talk about variables. I could never remember about independent and dependent variables because for a science experiment, that's what we do. We only change one thing. But we could never get kids to remember it. So we came up with this idea, and it's based on a cow. So we tell them that cows moo softly. It's a really stupid thing, but they remember it. And then we tell them for a scientific experiment, there's one thing that we change, one thing that we measure, and lots of things that we keep the same. When they get into year 9, and they start getting really grumpy and the hormones kick in, then we change it to... Does he look angry? Yeah. Okay, so we change it to, I don't care. And the kids remember that because, you know, we remember things which are, you know, dorky and silly. And then we put it as independent, dependent and constant. So it all fits in. Okay. Let's make our rockets. I'm going to... can I get you to throw those at people? Or you were taping. Can I get you to throw those at people for me? Terrific. Yes, yes. Here we go. I'll just take one. Yep, we'll have to toss out some sticky tape and a tick. Okay. Does anybody follow cricket? Okay. Are there any Indian cricket players in the room?
Shmi.
What Indian
cricket player?
Ah. Yes, please, yeah. Okay. One of the things you always find out from as a teacher's point of view, you never try and hand out equipment and talk at the same time. It never, ever works. But look, because we're short of time, This, we'll see who's actually gets to listen. Oh, no, don't, so you don't have to open these up. Keep them closed. This is our rocket. Yeah, so don't open up. I'll give you another one. Okay. I've sealed off one end completely with sticky tape. So if I was to place this one here on there and blow, nothing happens because there's nothing blocking it. So what we need to do is the end, which is going to be the tip, we've got to block it off totally with the sticky tape. And can I get you to catch for me, Brian? And can I get you just to cover your face so I don't... Just go like that. Go like that for me. Just cover your face. Yep. So you don't get hit. Okay, here we go. Was that good? Oh, okay. Right. Here's... I think I'm the only person in history that's actually landed at Dubai Airport with their own rocket launcher. So, okay. I need a volunteer to do some pumping, so you've got to be really strong. Yes, please. Terrific. Yeah, oh, you don't have to be too strong, but... Yep, just pump along. Big, sort of very super long ones. Excellent. Yep, that's it. I think we're going. Cool. Okay. Actually, can I get you to keep... I'm not going to... Not giving you a sack, but he's got more weight than you. Okay, thanks. Yeah. Cool. Okay. Right. Now, this is really super impressive. If you're in the back half, if you want to stand up where you are, can you see the cardboard box? So here we go. Yeah, perfect. Okay. What are we up to? Oh, that should do. That'll do. Yep. It didn't really want to... Just give it a really hard push. Yep. Cool. Okay. If you want to have the excitement, you've got to count down, okay? So we're going to do it from five, okay? And then I'm going to release it. All our air is going to go straight through and fire our rocket. So we're ready? Five, four, three, two, one. Oh. Okay, so it went through our... Now, okay, I'm going to give you the template for making some wings and for making the cone. The wings will be pretty straightforward. They just get cut up. The cone, the big trick, I normally get students to go outside and just get dirt or gravel, because the trick is, and is to actually put as much weight as possible into your cone. Okay, so we've got about 5 minutes, so we'll start making these. I'll give you the, yep, one of those each. Okay, so you're going to get the template to cut out and stick. Okay, so you've got sticky tape, we've got some staplers, and I'll give you some more scissors too. Okay, so it's going to be about 4 minutes. Here we go. More scissors. There we go. Terrific.
Thank you.
All right, they'll give you some of the tip. Here we go. Oh, I got it. Here we go. Okay, there we go. Oh, yeah. And what's this? Okay. Oh, there are more scissors there. Cool. Here we go, guys. Oh, there we are. Yep, I think we've got some more just in the chair out the front. Terrific. Okay, if you'd like some plasticine to go in your cone. Okay. There we go. Yep, tossing that, yep.
Is that one again?
Did we get scissors for you?
No, no. Oh. Thank
you. Are there any more of these? Can we panic sign?
I'll see if I can. There we go. Well done.
Okay.
You're welcome. And then we want to put some plasticine into that one.
Will you have plasticine?
Yeah. Yep, we've got some there.
Oh. How do we make the cone?
Oh, okay, I'll show you that. I'll give it for you.
A small bit or a big bit?
As much as you can put in.
Like inside it?
Yes. Yep.
Stick it with it as well?
So, really. Do we have
some?
It's your sticky tape. So I might just
like this.
Yep, as much as you can put in.
Excuse me, could you?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, I'm going to pinch some of yours. Sorry. Sorry. There we go. Here we are. Oh, this one's, normally we do it as an experiment, but this is, it's just for people to actually see what they can do back at school with their students. Here we go.
Okay. And then,
as much as you can put in.
Okay.
Perfect, that's it. You can probably put some more in there if you like.
Okay.
Oh, good.
Are we cutting this out?
Yeah, it does help, yeah.
I thought so.
Are we cutting it all out?
Yep.
And is the clay to make it heavier?
Yes, yep.
And then we're making it as tiny as right.
Yep, there we go. Do you have sticky tape? Oh, cool. That's okay.
How tiny.
She's sharing. Yep, so now, perfect. Put as much of that into there as possible.
As much of that into
yep.
here? Oh, okay. Put as much of that into
there
here.
There you go.
Into here?
Yeah, so you
into
want...
That. Now, how tiny do we make this one?
Oh, that's about right.
Yep.
There you go. Just squash it in. More tape?
So,
there we go. Yep.
And how should we this like this?
Yep. Yep. I'll get a staple for you and we'll work that out for you.
Do you want it to be like thin?
Okay, so you know you want as much of clay as possible.
So we'll fill it up with
yep.
the clay.
Yep. Perfect. Put some more in. It would be great.
Somebody took away our clay.
Ah.
Well,
there's heaps here. I'll get you some more. There's heaps there.
Nice, so good is it?
Yep. And now you have lots of clay.
Okay.
Can I just check? Oh, we put it on there.
Oh, shoot. Sorry.
That's right.
Okay.
Cool.
Oh, and with tape, I put them there.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I'm really not.
That's it?
Very handy. Thank you. Stapler. That make it a bit quieter.
Yeah.
Almost, yes.
Good, good.
Oh, a little bit of tape. Yes.
Yep.
Thank you.
We'll do it with this one.
Oh. Oh, so this
there you
is
go.
Quite heavy. Yes. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, that's it, actually, just so you can use that as a bookmark. But yeah, you don't, yeah, so you don't need that one. But these ones. Yep, perfect. There we go.
Okay, then.
Yep, and now.
Is it enough inside?
Yep, that'll be good.
Yeah.
And now make sure you put sticky tape on.
Where? Over there?
Yep, just to keep it in the spot in there. Yep. Yep, perfect.
And this is what?
And that goes on. Oh, you've got to clean. One side's got to be totally covered up.
Okay, then I have
and that goes on it. Yep.
And then you must take tape and.
Okay, we are supposed to dig it this.
Yep.
Like this.
So we've yes. so put sticky tape over there. Yeah, that's yep, and then that's all right. That's perfect.
Oh,
it's good. Okay, we're looking at one more minute.
So we have our.
Yep. So stick that on.
Yep.
Up there.
Sticky tape, yep.
And your wings. But my stapler's gone. Oh, tape, yeah, perfect. Oh, easy.
I like to put the wings together.
The wings don't make much of a difference anyway.
Oh, okay, they don't.
They're just cosmetic. And now sticky tape back
right,
to there.
Right.
There we go. And sticky tape back to there. Okay, so that's got to have tape over it.
Yeah, one side has
it. One side, yep,
yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yep, good. And then your cone goes onto there.
Okay. Right here.
Yep.
And then we tape it on, or we just...
Tape it on, yep. Be perfect.
That's a great one.
Hey, that's good. Yeah, that's awesome. That'll work good. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, give us 2 minutes and we'll fire on.
Yeah, just so when you can tell everybody that we're going to do them on the beach, so if everybody can just kind of follow... Put my hand up in the air.
Yeah, great.
And then I don't know if you wanted to finish it off on the beach, or if you want
to be. I think we. I can finish it off in here,
yeah,
and then we take
then,
them to the
yeah,
beach. Yeah,
yeah, exactly. And then people leave after they've done that.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it might be tricky for you to finish off. Doing brilliant.
Yeah, cool.
Really
oh, great.
Practice?
forward. Hey, perfect, cool. Yep, so just sticky tape that on there.
Tape down the middle.
Yep. That's it. I've just got to recap, and then we're going to go off to the beach and fire them off. Cool. How are we going? Good, good. You want to put some sticky tape on there?
Oh, okay.
Just to keep in. Awesome. I'm just going to switch yours around. Pop that on there, on that end.
Okay.
That's it. Perfect.
Perfect.
And you just want some sticky tape.
Yeah.
And in fact, let's put some more on.
You want to put more?
Yeah. Okay. Here we go. Oh, look, I'm impressed. I'm really super, super impressed. Okay. There will be some people who still need some time, so what I'm going to ask you to do is to multitask. Okay. Can I just put on some of the music? Okay. Oh, okay. Nice and loud. Okay, cool. And now just drop it down. Terrific. Okay. Music in the classroom, as well, some schools, they get kids to all put their hands up if the teacher needs to talk, or before we said about, you know, there's certain clues that you have for students if you want to have their attention. What I do in class is if we do busy work like this, where you don't need to be talking to me, then I'll put music on in the background. If I do need, though, to actually talk to the class, then what I'll do is I'll go up to the amplifier and I'll just suddenly turn it on full bore so you get this loud music and everybody then stops. Okay? If you're in a classroom and what I do is, and the students come in, I do it exactly like at the movies. I'll have the music on in the background, and then if I'm about to actually talk in a few minutes, I'll put the music level up so the excitement goes up, and then I will just turn it down over about 5 seconds. And it's amazing. That's that 5 seconds of kids will then be super quiet because, you know, there's this anticipation that something's about to happen, and then you've got their attention, then you can go forward and start to talk. Okay, if you are in the position that you still need to keep building, but everybody else just to listen. One of the things I love about this is, or a few things, it's dirt cheap, okay? I actually made these out of cardboard, but just plain A4 size paper does the trick. I have a Word document which has got the template that you've got to make it. There's a few extra bits I've placed on it because I didn't want to waste paper. So if students want to make a bookmark, they can cut that out. But you can put your own branding on this. So if you send me an email, and I'll just send it out to everybody that's with the Academy as a Word document. So you can put the name of your school, all these things on it. So when students go home with their rocket, they can actually talk about rockets at home. And especially for primary school kids, they love it. Okay, we're going to go out in about 1 minute to the beach, but that's where we'll close because I'm not going to ask you to all come back. And we're going to fire off the rockets. Now, can I tell you, one of the tricks that I've learnt is if you've got a large group, what you do is you make it so that everybody can see the rockets. So you've got to get people sort of in a bit of an arc so everybody can see the rockets go off. If it's, for example, 30 rockets that we're firing, then for probably about the first 10 or 15, I will fire the rockets off because the technique, and just to show you, this is just irrigation plumbing. So it's really dirt cheap to make. The trick to firing it off is once you've got the air pressure in there, you've got to turn this very, very fast. So I will organise it and I'll go through the know, the 5, 4, 3, get all the students, you know, in, you know, actively yelling out. And then I'll get some teachers from the school to actually do it, because teachers like to be able to take charge. And then if you can get some students to do it as well, it's a really super good photo opportunity to go back home. Okay, who needs more time on their rocket? We're all good? Okay, we're going to follow Rebecca. Rebecca, by the way, is absolutely terrific, because she's been looking after us. Can we just give her a clap? That's enough. We're going to follow Rebecca and
we're going to teach everybody.
Yep, terrific. So let's go.